Hello! I've learned how to say that today. We're learning that. Thank you so much, Michaela, for the introduction. Michaela has been a huge part of putting on Create, and she's doing amazing. So can we put on a big round of applause for Michaela? I am absolutely elated to be here today. I was elated before, and to be here on a day when we are making history with the announcements that are being made today, I feel I'm still vibrating in my body. I'm not sure if it's the nerves or it's the vibration from Santa's electric cello that we got to hear. I can say with confidence that this 14th batch of students in this room here today are some of the most driven and passionate. I got an opportunity to chat with a few of you here before coming up on stage. Congratulations on making it here. Whether you fully recognize it yet or not, and I'm going to echo some of the sentiments of Santa, your presence here and your willingness to lean into the teachings that this institution has to offer is a true gift to our city. Now, I can't speak for everyone in the room here today, but I'm confident that my esteemed peers and colleagues will echo me in saying, I'm so glad each and every single one of you are here. I've built my career on celebrating the rarity and beauty of this community. I love it with every fiber of my being. Like Michaela mentioned, my name's Jacklyn Robertson. I graduated in 2012 with a Bachelor of Arts degree in English and Psychology. And I recognize a few familiar hats and sweaters and t-shirts here in the crowd today, and so a few of you too might recognize me. I founded a local company in the Okanagan 5 years ago called Okanagan Lifestyle Apparel. Now, how many of you in the room here today, I'm curious, are from the Okanagan or surrounding areas? Show of hands. Awesome! And how many? Yeah, round of applause for that. Local. I love it. And how many of you are from out of province? Awesome. Incredible. And what about out of country? Woo! I love that. Round of applause for that. I love it. That's incredible. Those of you who are from here and who have spent your lives to this point traveling and exploring our vast mountains and lakes and trails know how truly incredible it is to be from here and how fortunate we are to live here. Those of you who are from out of province and out of country, welcome. You are in for a true treat in getting to study here and be on campus and a part of this incredible community. Now, I was at a local farm-to-table dinner this past winter, and the winemaker of Summerhill Winery, Eric von Grossick, said something to me that stuck with me, and I carry it with me, and I'm going to share it with you. And yes, I am quoting a local winemaker up here on stage today, and I think that is awesome. It's a tribute to where we live. He said this. He said, we are lucky three ways. We are lucky to live in Canada, we are lucky to live in BC, and we are lucky to live right here in the Okanagan. And the 3,000 plus of us that are here today in this room are now and forever connected to this incredible institution. We all are lucky four ways, at a very, very minimum. I wouldn't be standing up here today without many, many teachings from this very campus, a generous handful of incredible professors who, by the way, some are in the room here today, instilled in me enough confidence to be standing up here and doing things precisely like this, addressing some of the wisest minds that I've ever known, and also our incredible alumni association, who goes above and beyond to ensure that I stay connected to this incredible place of mind. Like a lasso over the past 7 years, they have pulled me in to incredible events and made sure that I do not lose sight of the resources available to me now that I have traveled through what you all are about to travel through. I'm so excited for the caliber of people that you are all about to get to know very well. Open yourself up to that. Get to know your professors. Some of them are standing here in the front row today. Get to know your student union, these amazing humans I got to chat with a little bit before I came up on stage. Ramal, who has amazing energy. I, Scouts Honor, promise you all that connecting with them, with your peers, your colleagues, will make your time here brighter. Now, standing up here today, my feet planted firmly in the present moment, I remember, like it was yesterday, vividly, being just like you. And I'll echo what Ramal said. I remember sitting in these chairs, wishing near the end that the damn speakers would hurry up so we could get on with the day. And so I won't ramble. Your time is precious. And as you travel through these next few years, as you have your deadlines and your papers and all these things that are gonna be due, you're gonna have a really solid understanding of how precious time is. So I'm not going to ramble. But the perspective and lesson that I care to offer to you all deeply today requires a 1 minute backstory. So stick with me, we're almost at the end here. 3 weeks into my university career, I received a phone call from my brother in the middle of the night saying, Dad has had a massive stroke. He has lost all ability to communicate, losing words. We don't know if he's gonna make his way back. My dad was a successful business owner his entire life, so that was a huge hit for our family. 3 weeks into my university career, I had one of the hardest decisions of my life to make to that point in time. Do I quit school and support my family in their healing, or do I continue on and lean into my professors and my peers and ask questions and lean on them when I need support? I consciously chose to stay and to continue on. And I am not at all ashamed to say I needed a lot of help. I asked for a lot of help, and I received a lot of amazing help. Like Ramal said, do not forget the faces in this room here today and the amazing hundreds of other faces you're going to meet. We are in this together. I am 7 years out of where you are now, and if any of you ever need anything, you call on me. Don't forget my face. We are here to help. We're in this together. Watching my dad lose his ability to employ language, to communicate even his basic needs that year, taught me very deeply to be responsible for the energy that I bring to a space. Still to this day, the form of communication that he best understands is body language and energy. So here's my challenge to all of you. As you continue on with your day-to-day, as you tour around campus and you get to meet some of our faculty, be present and responsible for the energy that you bring into a space. And we got to see this earlier when Santa's playing the cello and Mike is rocking out and we had our volunteers over here with their phones and they were singing and dancing and we slowly, contagiously, that energy filled the whole room. And one by one, we all made that choice to either sit there and be crouched down or, you know, it started with a little toe tap, for me anyway, clapping our hands, and then before we knew it, the entire room was standing and dancing and cheering. It's contagious. Don't forget that. Carry that vibration with you. Check yourself often. Are you taking this moment, this opportunity for granted? Are you slouched over and uninterested? Or are all of your cells standing at attention, curious, interested in what you're about to learn in this experience? I invite you tomorrow, your first day of classes, the day after that, and the day after that, continue to check yourself. My hope for you all is that the energy that you carry with you uplifts and contagiously inspires, just like we saw earlier. I hope the energy that you carry with you is conducive to vast learning. I hope the energy that you all carry with you opens up an unlimited number of doors en route to your success, however it is that you define success. I hope to see you all again at the end of this month. Like Professor Buzzard said, the Homecoming Street Fest party, September 28th, I will be there. We will have an Okanagan Lifestyle booth set up. I can't wait to see you all again. I can't wait to hear about your first month here on campus and the energy that you all chose to bring for that first month. I can't wait to hear about your wins, your failures, the hardships, where you asked for help, who you asked for help. And lastly, my final piece of advice that I have for you today, when you walk this stage, like Ramal said, in 2 years, 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, however long it takes you all to accomplish your goals, when you succeed, don't be too cool to tap your toe, to celebrate, to invite people in. Don't be too cool to not invite your parents, your spouses, your friends, to share in all that you're about to learn here. Learn from me. I played it way too cool. I waited until the last possible minute to invite my mom to convocation. She attempted to make it here. She drove through about 6 literal floods to try to make it to watch me walk the stage. And in the end, she never made it. But you know what? She's here today. And I'm thrilled to have her. I love you. I'm not too cool to give my mom a shout out up on stage here. And so, I'm thrilled to have you, and I asked my friends at the alumni office to do me a little favor. And so, Mom, this one's for you. I love you.